Nice job walking.
Doctors predicted Vivian wouldn't walk until she was 5, but before age 3, she took off, unfazed by the barriers before her.
My whole world was turned upside down in a matter of a minute.
Leah Henriksen of St. Paul was ready to take Vivian home from the hospital when doctors took note of her rash and failed hearing test. The diagnosis that followed would bring Leah here.
Thank you so much for being here.
A U of M Masonic Children's Hospital conference increasing awareness of cytomegalovirus, or CMV.
There were very significant abnormalities in terms of the brain development for this infant.
CMV is sort of like Zika without the mosquito. It's a virus that everyone is exposed to eventually. And most people, it's of no consequence unless you happen to be pregnant. And then the consequences can be very devastating for the baby.
A common virus circulating daycares can present with cold or flu-like symptoms or none at all. So why isn't it talked about more?
The fact that I'd never heard of it, and I already had a 2.5-year-old, I'd read all the books, and I'd never heard of it, was sort of a paralyzing experience.
So Leah became the force behind a bill urging the state to educate women of childbearing age about CMV risks.
The Vivian Act.
With Representative Kelly Fenton's help, it almost made its way into law this year.
I don't regret it for a second.
But the mission continues to lobby for universal screenings.
That is to say, should all babies be tested at birth for CMV?
For Vivian, a mother's wish is to help just one family like hers.
The more you know, the more you're able to treat early, and outcomes are far better.
So if caught early, there is a medication to treat CMV. It also can even reverse hearing loss in some cases. Research is also underway at the U of M for a vaccine. And this is so interesting, Corey. Like Leah, I only learned about CMV with the birth of my second child. My daughter, Phoebe, is almost 2, and she has hearing loss, and only recently has she been tested for CMV. She doesn't have it. But now if a child is born at the U and they fail their hearing test, they will automatically test for CMV as a standard of care. But when my daughter was born about a year and a half ago, they didn't test for CMV.
Right, so this is all really brand new.
Very, very new, on the cusp.
So there's still a lot we need to learn about it.
Yes, and you said you didn't know about it either.
No, yeah, with our 3 kids, same thing, 3.5 and under. Had never heard of this until we talked about it today.
Yeah, so the awareness is beginning and hopefully growing.
Oh, wonderful story. Thank you, Lindsay.
Thank you.